New and dramatic details this hour in the urgent investigation into a Christmas morning explosion. Police say officers responded to reports of gunfire in downtown Nashville early this morning when they stumbled on an RV playing a recorded warning that a bomb would detonate within 15 minutes. Officers then sprinted to clear the area, and then the RV delivered on that promise. That is the sound of sheer terror in the magnitude of that explosion. At a news conference last hour, police say quick action by first responders saved lives.
They went to the residential areas on 2nd Avenue and did their best to get people to safety. Obviously, they heard the announcements coming from this vehicle. They took them seriously and were working to seal the streets to protect folks. And we think it worked. We think lives were saved by those officers doing just that.
Some heroic actions, no doubt. The explosions happened near the AT&T building in the downtown corridor. The building is the tallest in the state. The scene showed the explosion's destructive power. 2nd Avenue now lined with charred trees and shattered glass. The city's mayor says the explosion damaged 20 buildings in the area. The Tennessee governor says he'll commit whatever resources are required to find out who was responsible. Miraculously, only 3 people were injured, and doctors say those injuries are not life-threatening. Authorities say that as of now, they have no motive and no suspects, though local FBI officials are already taking control of the investigation. Let's get right to CNN security correspondent Josh Campbell. Josh, federal law enforcement getting involved very quickly here. What are your sources telling you about this incident?
Yeah, hi, Bianca. We've talked to so many sources, and at this point, the reason why we're not hearing details is because we're told that, in a sense, they're simply baffled. They don't have many leads right now on specifically what transpired. The details at this point, just so bizarre. As you mentioned, authorities were called just after the 6 o'clock hour there in downtown Nashville to reports of shots fired, that obviously bringing authorities down to that location. And when they got there, they heard this sound coming from this parked RV saying that this bomb would detonate in 15 minutes. Authorities then working very quickly to try to move people out of that area. Obviously, early morning on a Christmas day, there weren't a lot of people, but there was at least one residential building there nearby as well. And as you mentioned, about 15 minutes after they heard that, that explosion happened, just a massive explosion. I talked to one law enforcement source who says that the amount of explosives that were in that vehicle is something that they haven't seen, at least in modern memory, in the United States. Certainly, even in other places around the world. So just causing sheer chaos down there and obviously widespread destruction. Now, what we don't yet know from authorities is whether anyone was inside that vehicle whenever it was detonated, whether the person who may have made this device was a casualty or whether they have a manhunt underway. I just talked to a law enforcement source before we came on the air who said that they still don't know. They're processing that scene in order to try to determine whether there was anyone inside the vehicle. We do know that the Federal Bureau of Investigation is now the lead agency working with their federal partners. We're told that they are surging resources from other offices to try to assist in gathering information. I am told by a law enforcement source that there were no known credible threats to the Nashville area that would indicate any type of attack on or before Christmas. And so really, Bianca, authorities just baffled right now about this event that took place. We do know that based on what transpired, it does not look as though this person who committed this act was trying to cause mass loss of life for the very fact that there was this warning, this voice recording that was going off. So very puzzling, and a very wide, large investigation underway right now by state, federal, local authorities, Bianca.
Yeah, so bizarre. I continue to be stunned when I look at those live shots there of the devastation there from the explosion. And Josh, what was interesting from the police chief is that while he said he's not talking about any leads, he also asked the public for any help, any information that they could provide. What does that tell you as far as where they are in opening this investigation and starting to find who the perpetrators are?
They're trying to gather information from any witnesses. We know also that there's a technical investigation underway to try to gather as much CCTV footage in and around that area that may have captured this RV being parked, perhaps the driver, any other key details. But as you mentioned, they're also trying to crowdsource, as we see in so many of these investigations where the FBI, the top agent there in the Nashville area, was standing in front of a microphone and camera saying, you know, the public, we need your help. If you have any information, we need that information. Information to try to piece things together. And as we often hear from them, you know, no piece of information is insignificant. Anything that they know that might help in trying to identify the person or persons responsible, they want to know. What is interesting, Bianca, is that we have seen in past investigations where if authorities have the identity of someone, it will either go two ways. Either if they think they know where this person is, sometimes they may not release that information. They don't want to tip the person off. They want to amass the amount of federal resources necessary to try to surround and take that person into custody. But also we've seen it go the other way, where if they know the identity but they don't have leads, they may start blasting that information out to the public, the name, the face, the identifiers. But what we're told right now is that they are simply so early in this investigation, they don't know whether they have a deceased, a bomb maker inside this vehicle, or whether they have a manhunt that they need to launch. But just a Herculean task that are ahead of by investigators with so many resources surging into Nashville.
Yeah, federal resources, they're pouring in. The one reassuring thing, aside from the few casualties and they were not significant injuries, is that the police there feel fairly confident that the area is now safe within the next few hours. Josh Campbell, thank you so much. We appreciate it.
Thanks, Bianca.
And joining me now to share his insights is CNN senior law enforcement analyst and former acting director of the FBI, Andrew McCabe. Andrew, Merry Christmas to you. Didn't expect to be talking to you on this Christmas morning, but that's what happens in live television. Thank you for coming on. Authorities were fairly quick to call this an intentional event. What would give them confidence to do that in the immediate hours after the explosion?
Well, that was the question we were all really chewing on initially. But I think with the most recent press conference, where they indicated that, of course, they got the call for shots fired, that drew law enforcement to the area. And then as they approached the RV, they said that there was some sort of a megaphone or announcement emanating from the RV that indicated that an explosion might be possible in the next 15 minutes. So that explains first, of course, why they would why they've concluded that this was an intentional act. And secondly, it also explains why the police officers very quickly went to the surrounding residences and kind of warned folks to leave the area quickly to keep people safe.
Yeah, and they, as the police chief said there, no doubt saved lives in doing so in those 15 minutes. Earlier this morning, and again, this is before this press conference when we got more information about that recorded message coming out of the RV warning that the explosion would detonate in 15 minutes, you had called this and said that this had the hallmarks of domestic terrorism. Do you still feel that way? And when does that classification come into effect if, in fact, this perpetrator may not have wanted mass casualties?
Yeah, so to be clear, Bianca, at this point, we don't know if this is an act of domestic terrorism or if this may have been conducted by people who are inspired by or followers of international terrorists, foreign terrorist groups. We just don't know that at this point. However, it's pretty clear that an intentional massive explosive device set on a city street, this is some sort of act of terrorism. That's at least the way the FBI looks at it. They will initially utilize the full panoply of their counter-terrorist resources to attack this problem. Now, whether it's a domestic group that is pursuing some sort of political agenda here. We've certainly seen a lot of that in the last few months, anti-government groups, white supremacist groups, things like that. That may be the case. We don't know. If it's a foreign group seeking to, you know, advance their political agenda, we just don't know that at this point. We have got to attach some people to this event before they'll be able to make that sort of assumption.
which will happen once we have federal resources on the ground there now. And earlier, we had said that this explosion had taken place right outside of the AT&T building. It's the largest building in the state. It now appears to have taken place outside of a different building, but just gives you the scope of the explosion when you can't really pinpoint where exactly this RV was parked and where it was detonated. But when you hear the police say that they have no concern about additional devices, that isn't something I would imagine they just guess and come out and say publicly. So what would give them the confidence to announce that to the public? They may not be letting local residents back into the area, but it is reassuring to hear them say they don't believe there are additional devices.
It certainly is, and they're confident saying that because they've done a sweep of the general area using things like bomb dogs and just law enforcement officers to check vehicles, to check residences, that sort of thing. So they're, you know, it is a low traffic time of day, 6:30 a.m. on a Christmas morning, so there's not going to be a lot of people or vehicles in the area. So that makes that task a little bit easier.